Hey, welcome to Facebook Live from yourstory.com. I'm your business editor, Vishal Krishna, and I'm with my friend Vikas Lachwani of M Caffeine. It's not a cigarette company, by the way. It's a skincare brand. And welcome to yourstory.com.
Pleasure to be here.
How are you?
I'm doing fantastic.
So, you know, I think it's the first budget where there's a structural capital shift in presenting something on finance. Like, we didn't talk about BDs, we didn't talk about cigarettes, we didn't talk about biscuits.
Yeah.
We spoke about what should be done, right?
Yes.
So, do you want to tell me about why this budget spoke about SMEs and why SME lending is finally freed up?
Right.
And nobody noticed that, by the way.
So, if you allow me like a few more seconds, so let's see what has happened. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So far the budgets used to be that, you know, what has happened to each and every individual item, you know, tax
mm-hmm.
going up on one item
mm-hmm.
and second item
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
going down on the others depending on, you know, how populist or,
right.
You know, financially important that budget is. But now this time, because we had all that during the GST discussions
mm-hmm.
and, you know, post-GST reforms and all that, I think there was a bit more focus available in this budget for what you call the structural capital shift.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in this thing, so that's what is happening. So if you look at some of the most fundamental things that have happened in this budget is, I mean, there are some directives that there will be more money available for MSMEs through
mm-hmm.
online lenders.
Okay.
These were like spaces which had slightly less regulations in the past. They need
mm-hmm.
a bit more regulation. They need a bit more freedom to operate.
So you're saying I can go to any of these online companies and register and take credit?
And it will be available at a better rate, hopefully,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
let the whole story unfold. But it's very important to have that easier access to capital.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But I think the biggest thing over here is the introduction of the long-term capital
okay.
gains tax.
Okay.
Right? So,
why do you say that? I mean, I know equities are not taxed in the past.
Right.
Correct.
So,
correct me if I'm wrong.
You're absolutely
mm-hmm.
right. So, long-term capital gains
mm-hmm.
was completely tax exempt in the case of listed
mm-hmm.
equities.
Mm-hmm.
And by long-term, it was 12 months and above.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Short-term was taxed, but long-term was tax-free. Now, I'll say it from a startup standpoint,
yes.
being a startup. So, startups are unlisted equities, right? I mean,
right.
startup companies are not listed in the stock
mm-hmm.
market. And these unlisted equities, they were taxed. Even for long-term capital gains tax.
Okay,
right?
You guys are taxed, yes.
Yeah. So if somebody invests in a startup,
mm-hmm.
you know, sells that equity after some
mm-hmm.
time, that is taxed despite being more than, you know,
I
in this
it,
case
yeah.
it was 36 months actually.
Mm-hmm.
So now it creates a bit more level playing field.
Okay.
For some investor who was not looking to invest in startups only because, you know, investing in listed equities, even in small companies, because that's where a lot of growth potential is.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they can now shift to, you know, startups and invest more money over there.
Very interesting. Very interesting.
And hopefully that will bring a lot more accelerated growth and,
mm-hmm.
You know, see, at the end of the day, startups have a bit more,
mm-hmm.
I like to believe, hunger
mm-hmm.
and the need to reach out to the market and do something bigger, better, faster,
mm-hmm.
right? And let the capital come to that. And we'll be happy if that happens.
So, what do you think? I mean, the tax collected from this also can become a pool for startups.
It can become a pool for startups, especially the startups which are serving at the bottom. So if
mm-hmm.
you look at where did this money come from,
mm-hmm.
it was who invests in, you know,
HNIs,
you know, people who have that excess capital.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then this is the gain on top of that investment. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So when government takes that, you know, piece of that away,
mm-hmm.
that actually goes to the government and hopefully with all the right intent that
yeah, it comes back to Startup India.
So Startup India and the bottom of the pyramid, right,
mm-hmm.
for all the good things.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, even startups need good infrastructure and
mm-hmm.
you also need good facilities
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
The population evolves, great for everyone.
And there was a lot of talk of bringing PF down, and which they did.
Right.
And you tell me numbers where they brought it down from 12% for women to 8% now. So that contribution of money that can now be invested by businesses. Or is that a wrong way of looking at it?
So,
how do you measure that?
So two things.
Is it a touchy topic? You know, women?
It's a touchy topic.
Yeah.
Right? So women will have a bit more access to capital.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, it will go towards spends a little.
Mm-hmm.
In an ideal world, you would still want to invest this money for their future and, you know, into the right investment. The good thing is they have a choice.
So yeah, they have 4%
right.
more that has to their purse.
So personally, instead of me being greedy that, you know, there's 4%
yeah.
more money from women coming in because they're not
mm-hmm.
investing, yeah, well, let that rather be invested and
mm-hmm.
as long as they're doing that, it'll come
so
to us.
So you're trying to invest in, not in gold, but in equities now, or what do you think they should invest that money in?
Some may invest in startups.
Startups, yeah, so go buy. Go buy equity in startups. That's a good thing. But you know, this is what confuses me. They do all this for the startup of easing of lending, you know, getting money into the system by taxing equities, creating a level playing field, and then they don't talk about angel tax. That looks seems like an irony, right?
Right. It's an irony. I mean, that's one thing that should be straightened a little. I mean, there should be a bit more government focus towards that.
Mm-hmm.
Because while, you know, the stage has been set for more money to shift from listed companies to startups,
mm-hmm.
but at the same time, a little bit of uncertainty around things like this angel tax, I mean, it's a deterrent. I mean,
mm-hmm.
for somebody who is not well-versed with what's going on, they
mm-hmm.
prefer to stay away.
Correct.
But there's a little bit more clarity on that.
Mm-hmm.
And we all know that, you know, how startups are funded, how the money comes in. It's not an income for
startups. There's more of a KYC.
Right.
Then punish the person.
Right, because it's an investment, it's not an income for a startup.
Mm.
Right? And I think that will be a good thing for the whole startup ecosystem if that
mm.
can be, you know, streamlined
mm.
a little.
And personally, as a brand, what did you expect? As a company that also manufactures out of India, I think you get it out of local manufacturers,
right.
You also retail it in various places, including
right.
online e-commerce companies, right?
Right? Right.
What did you expect personally as a company?
So frankly speaking, I mean, there's always that iota of greed saying that, you know, can we get an extra percent here or a percent there, you
mm-hmm.
know, whether it is in saving that percent in manufacturing or saving that percentage in retail and so on.
Mm-hmm.
But to be honest, I mean, there's so much to gain in the Indian economy if we are able to get a platform
mm-hmm.
to grow more than anything else.
Mm-hmm.
If there is a chance to grow like 500x,
yeah.
then it's okay not to bother about that saving that 1% here or 1% there and so on. So it's always great to get that 1%. I mean, we'll take it any day, you know, whenever it comes
mm-hmm.
our way. For example, recently it happened during GST reforms that, you know, some product categories of ours, they shifted from 20%
yeah.
to 18%.
So it came down to you, right?
Right.
Yeah.
So it was...
What is the rate now for you?
It's 18%.
18%. From 28. It was called a luxury good in our world, I'm 18.
Right. So that was hugely beneficial.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, we can choose not to bother about that extra 1% here and there in lieu of this fantastic reform that have happened. And
mm-hmm.
hopefully... The way we are trying to see it, if the money actually comes towards the startup ecosystem, nothing
fantastic.
Like that, right?
You know, the good thing that Digital India has talked a lot about, but everything around robotics and AI, do you think there should be something done for digital brands like you? I mean, I know you manufacture,
right.
but you sell digitally.
Right.
Should there have been something like that? Because the government talked about agri and e-nam, right? Agricultural marketing through an online portal,
right.
connecting farmers to mandis. Could they have done similar? Could they have announced similar shops to people like you?
So this is one thing that we are in personal care, so at some point of time you can tell us that, you know, we are a bit more superfluous than basic human hygiene and needs and so
mm-hmm.
on. But frankly speaking, if there was a way to go and, you know, reach out on some like very basic needs,
mm-hmm.
either we'll do it or many of us are, you know, many of our fellow startups will actually go there and do it, because now the accessibility, because of this new ecosystem of new logistics and
mm-hmm.
new e-commerce systems, a lot can be done over there. Right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's a slightly hazy area because it's not a completely evolved area per se.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's a lot of innovation happening over
is,
there.
Is it also because a lot of it has been related to the tax ecosystem in India? Therefore, it's in silos, right? The brands in silos, the logistics is in silos,
right?
The distribution ecosystem itself, right? So
mm-hmm.
Do you think that should have been brought out in the budget at all?
I think it will take a little bit of time.
Mm-hmm.
Because
there was some announcement on logistics, if I remember.
Right.
I think a brand like yours benefits from a logistics kind of marketplace.
Right.
But
I think a government will need a dedicated forward-looking think tank to
mm-hmm.
try and predict things which, you know, new people are trying to work on. So
mm-hmm.
typically, I mean, we have been doing everything in retrospect.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I mean, when e-commerce came in India, let's suppose 5, 7, 8 years back,
right.
everybody was trying to figure out, you know, how this business is going to work. But instead of trying to wait and sit today as to what has happened 5 years back, let's try to project, you know, how the market is shaping up for the next 5 years.
Yeah.
So that will give us a fantastic visibility. That will give us a fantastic visibility to people who are trying to invest in this ecosystem. And I think it will also be a fantastic opportunity for government and the bigger players to create that ecosystem
yeah.
where, you know, other people can come and play and create a better India, basically.
So there you have it, Vikas's analysis of the budget. You give it a thumbs up, don't you?
Yeah, it's a great budget.
It's a great budget, but then again, you know, we think that you know, the budget could have done more in terms of angel tax.
That's one clarity which we seriously have.
That's about it. That's one common theme, and look forward to seeing you in our next video. Thank you very much.
Thanks
for
having us here.
Thank you. Thank you.